the challenges?
There's two challenges with legal cannabis in the United States for adult use, and those are IRS code section 280E and the banking issue. I like to say when we fix those two issues, we'll have a real industry for adult use cannabis in the United States, whether for medical or fully legal. And IRS code section 280E, the short version is that for constitutional purposes, all your costs of growing the plant or purchasing the product are deductible, but your retail expenses are not. Retail rent, retail labor, advertising, health insurance, 401k are all not deductible at the IRS code's interpretation of IRS code section 280E, which was really designed to keep drug dealers from writing off their Uzis and their bullets and their costs of selling cocaine and other drugs. It spun off of an old tax court case in 82 called the Edmondson case. And that's the short version of IRS code section 280E, which the IRS is enforcing vigorously against the industry. The upshot of that is some of my clients can find themselves in excess of 100% tax brackets. Shifting over to the banking issue, it is virtually impossible under the Bank Secrecy Act and the anti-money laundering laws for a bank to take on a business, a cash-based business that's federally illegal. They just can't do it. So it's a big challenge. A lot of dispensaries are doing $1 million a month or more in cash. They pay their employees in cash. They pay the IRS in cash. They pay the state of Colorado. They pay all their sales tax and withholding taxes in cash. So the IRS and the state of Colorado now have money counting machines and separate rooms to bring the cash to with witnesses so you can walk out with a receipt when you pay your taxes in cash. Big challenge. They pay their rent in cash. I make sure that my clients issue 1099s and follow the $10,000 limits for cash transactions and follow the proper forms. So the cash is really a challenging issue. Most of my clients have some banking, very limited banking, but they really can't use it. In other words, if you walk into your bank with $10,000 or $20,000 every other day in cash, it doesn't matter what business you're in. It could be a car wash or a grocery store. The bank is going to ask a lot of questions to comply with their AML and Bank Secrecy Act laws. So that is the two biggest challenges to the industry. They will get fixed at some point. The question is, of course, when?